This is the end, 2013. This is of one of these Armageddon movies, but it's a comedy, and it's a bloody good one. These people go to a party, a big Hollywood party, and there's lots of drugs and booze and all that stuff, like, you know, you would expect, right? Well, while it's happening, the world ends, basically. The two of them take off to go to the store, and witness the rapture, basically. Well, one of them does. One of them's trapped under a thing, and he doesn't see the rapture happening. But, you know, they get back to the house, and nobody knows what's going on, right? They didn't feel the earthquake. They didn't notice anything. And the one guy is trying to describe what's going on with the rapture. People, beams of light and people being sucked up into the sky. And they're like, what are you talking about? And of course, his friends are like, I didn't see nothing. But yeah, then it gets really weird, really real. The house shakes, the wall cracks. They all go running outside. LA's in ruins. There's just fire and holes in the ground everywhere, right? And, of course, then the lawn opens up and a bunch of them die, and there's not too many of them live, right? So they're back in the house, and they're trying to survive and stuff like that. And that's how the movie goes from then on in. Yepers, 7 out of 10. It was pretty damn funny. The Batman 2022, I think this is the most well-defined of the Batman movies ever. Lots of action, lots of violence. It's really dark. I mean, they went really dark with the character. They went really dark with the villains. It was just great. And the best Catwoman ever. I mean, just the best Catwoman ever. You betcha. Not much else to say. It's your typical Batman movie. It's super worth a watch, though. 10 out of 10. After Earth 2013, this is not the best Will Smith movie ever, or the best movie ever. Anyways, Earth has been abandoned because of disaster. You know, we've ruined the planet. We left it. So this is many centuries later. Will Smith and the character that Will Smith plays, that is, and his son. Little flies are bothering me, man. They won't die. Anyways, they crash land on Earth, which is, of course, an abandoned planet, and it's come back. Nature has reclaimed the planet. It's beautiful now, right? Lots of tension between the father and the son, of course, because, you know, that's how Hollywood portrays father-son relationships in adventure movies. So, you know, I know better. I'm such a great grown-up thing, right? You know. Anyways, lots of angst. Yeah, it's not that great. It's the visuals are spectacular, and I gave it an extra point for that. I would have given it a 4 out of 10 if the visuals weren't so great. IMDb, it's a 4.3 or something, or 4.8 or something like that. I'm gonna give it a 5. Gods of Egypt 2016. Anyways, this is visually spectacular, but it's not that great, if you ask me. It got a pass on IMDb, but I'm going to give it a 4 out of 10. Anyways, a mortal teams up with a couple of the Egyptian gods to fight Set, which is the god of darkness, who's pretty much trying to destroy humanity, or Egypt anyways. And yeah, they have to save against the army of Set and whatnot to return Egypt to prosperity, peace and prosperity. Yippers, 4 out of 10. Just meh. Choose or die. So this young coder has a retro computer, and he's fired up a game, a horror adventure type game from the 1980s. And it, of course, unleashes a curse because, you know, it's a horror movie, right? Anyways, entity makes them do either horrible things to themselves or they will die. One or the other. So, yeah, it's pretty basic and it's pretty simple. It's exactly what you think it's going to be. IMDb did not give this a pass. It's a 4.8 on IMDb, so most people did not like it. I gave it a pass, 5 out of 10. Mowgli, Legend of the Jungle, 2018. This is the Jungle Book story, of course, with Mowgli and the bear and the panther and the snake and the wolves and all that. Basically, he's raised by wolves and whatnot and the jungle creatures. If you've not read the Jungle Book as a kid, you missed out. Anyways. It's your typical Disney type story, even though it's not Disney. You betcha. It's a kids' movie, but it's really enjoyable. It's a family-friendly movie, but it's got something for everyone. It's got a little bit of humor, even though the humor is a little bit subdued. It's got action. It's got really nice animation. Yeah, what can I say? I've watched this movie twice over the last couple of years. I just rewatched it. So, yeah, I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10, which is more than most people did. Have a good one.